one each.
I would like to.
Yes, please.
I want this one in particular.
I want that one as well.
and they are.
This is the Taylor GT series guitars. And now we've picked the nicest ones for this video.
Yeah, yeah.
Because that's what we do.
In love.
Walk around the shop and we go, what are we going to do video on? The nice stuff.
Why not?
Yeah.
Live a little.
Yeah. So GT series.
GTs.
This is all new for Taylor. And Andy Powers has once again created something new.
Yep.
Well, actually, he's created a whole lot of new things for this guitar.
Yeah, yeah. I think a couple of tweaks needed to be made for it to exist.
Yep. So, obviously, if you haven't been paying attention, which I think anyone who's looking at a Taylor video has been paying attention, he invented the V-Class bracing. The V-Class bracing exists now, thanks to Andy Powers. And from that, he's continued to evolve guitar.
Yeah, so traditionally there was an X brace on the underside of the soundboard.
Yep.
Then there was a big V on the V-Class guitars that Taylor do.
Yep.
And now we've got C-Class on these.
Yes.
It's not on any of the other guitars that they
have. No, it's only for this guitar. Yep. So I think basically because he basically wanted to evolve the GS Mini, right?
Yep.
And then get something different to take it to the next level, he had to redesign the bracing.
Mm.
So we've got what's called C-Class. It's from a cantilever, which is basically means we've got a bracing across here, we've got a brace across here, and a brace across here. So no bracing on this side.
Right.
So think about like a crane, kind of holding the one piece here, holding the top up.
Fascinating. And this kind of is like a blinged out GS Mini, right? Like it's a small guitar, it's a short scale length. Okay,
massive reflections from my guitar. I'll hold it down. There we go. It's better. People are gonna be like, turn your guitar flat, dude. Well, we're saying GS Mini, it is a blinked out GS Mini, let's be honest. It's bigger than GS Mini, so it's 24 1/8 scale length.
Mm-hmm.
So it's longer than a GS Mini, but shorter than the 25 and a bit scale length that's normal to a Taylor.
Yeah.
So,
and as a result, it feels really slinky to play. It's like super, super forgiving, really, isn't it? And
yeah.
Fast. I feel like I can fly around it.
I think if you're an electric guitar player, you're going to find this is just easier because the tension's not the same. You know, it is, like you said, it's slinkier to get around.
And I feel like the smaller body, I feel like I'm not like trying to get around it, you know, one of any of their big ones. Like it's like really comfortable little shape to sit and play.
Yeah.
And then, you know, standing up holding it before, and I feel like I could just wield it.
But it doesn't look like you're holding a tiny guitar. I'm just looking at you in the thing. Yeah, it looks. You can totally gig with that without feeling like you're holding a tiny guitar, unless you're 8 feet tall. Then
yeah,
it look like you're holding a tiny guitar, no matter what you're holding.
Yeah.
Like a jumbo.
Yeah.
But I mean, like, so it's the grand. Basically, the grand theater is a shrunken grand orchestra shape. And. It's just really comfortable to sit and play with. So like whether you're playing on the couch or playing in a studio or whatever,
yeah.
I think it's a good little pocket rocket, right?
Yeah, for sure.
To pick up and play.
Yeah. So your one
is
part of the K series, right?
That is correct. So this is the GT K21e, right? So yes, it's part of the K series. So we're talking all solid Koa timber, Koa back and sides, top, fine inlays. You know, all the usual appointments for a K series.
Yeah, this is a GT 811E spruce.
Sitka spruce.
Sitka spruce top.
East Indian rosewood back and sides.
Amazing, look at that back.
So kind of all, I mean, the standard spec for this series, right? So, you know, all the same glues, the wooden scratch plate, same inlays for the series.
Same finish.
Basically, it fits that series. It's just that new shape.
Yeah, yeah. I'm in love with it.
Mm.
I think this is probably one of my favorite Taylors that I've played. Like
especially that one.
Yeah.
Look, Koa. They always say, you know, Koa is an instrument, a wood that kind of takes to be played in a little bit. So this is a little bit stiff.
Okay.
Straight out of the box.
Yeah.
Some people like a kind of a brightness to it, but Koa warms out over time.
Yeah.
Rosewood just immediately for like a little guitar. It doesn't sound like a little guitar.
Yeah, there's heaps of bottom end in there. Hopefully that's coming through on the recording. At the moment, we're just running directly out of the pickup system.
Yep.
and I'm dipping the room mics that we're using for our voices whenever we play. So you're hearing straight up out of the pickups, and it's a really organic kind of acoustic sound coming out of the pickups, isn't
it? Oh, we were listening to it before when we're setting up.
Yeah.
I mean, like the... like how that sounds, it translates.
Yeah. So I mean, that's really cool. But yeah, the bottom end in for a small guitar like this is pretty crazy, isn't it?
Look, I mean, you know, with Taylor's, it's always kind of, they say it's finding your fit, right? So each model, there's these two, there's also an Urban Ash model, which is kind of the entry point. They all sound different. It's always up to the player what you enjoy, right?
Yeah.
For me, I enjoy Rosewood. It's kind of, it's the recorded sound, right?
I feel like you and me kind of have sort of similar playing styles, and this really seems to fit the type of playing that I want to do. I don't know, and most people don't know me, or you. So we like to, you know, we like to strum a bit, but we also like to do some finger picking, and this feels like it could be an all rounder.
It's definitely an all rounder.
I mean, chordal. Chords sound really good, finger picking. Cool.
I dropped a swear word. There we go.
You have to. It's a celebratory swear word.
You know, the more I play this, and I think that's maybe one of the things about Coleman, the more you play it, the more you start to kind of find its voice.
Acoustically, it sounds a little bit more scooped than this one. This one's got like a mid-range presence that kind of...
And yeah, there's not quite the same bottom end in this guy. So definitely playing that. I don't know, that's like, Spruce and Rosewood is just like that sound you're used to.
Yeah. Yeah.
But it's like kind of the one that I lean to all the time with most guitars.
Yeah, for sure.
So don't take us like we're going, the K is not great, because the K is great, and you know, like, especially for, it's always about the player. You know, somebody will come in and play this and play that, and this will be their voice.
Yeah.
Plus, look how bleed this thing is.
It's ridiculous. The figure, you know, in the wood is mental. It's like 3D, you know, especially, show the back. See if you can get that without a reflection. It's wild.
Maybe not.
Yeah, maybe it'll come up.
Oh, yeah, kind of. Yeah, there we go.
So good.
Look, I mean, I do love Koa, but I definitely find that it needs a bit more time to kind of not feel so stiff.
Yeah.
Whereas that just immediately sounds...
Yeah, amazing. So, I mean, the sound's one thing, the shape is another, like, it's obviously really comfortable. This guitar would be really suited to a touring musician.
Let's talk about the bag.
Yeah, because it comes with this amazing bag as well. So, small guitar, comes in a soft, hardish, softish case.
We could stand on it.
Yeah.
Let's do that thing where we throw it off a building again.
Okay. It was one time.
Yeah, we're not doing that Taylor thing. So yeah, I mean, like, super plush, and you know, it's solid, right? So
yeah, what's that? There's got a ridge in there. Is that a piece of metal running down the front of it?
Let's cut it open and see what happens. Yeah. Dumb ideas, Tim. It's got something solid down the thing. So yeah. You can stand on that, put it on a plane.
Yeah.
I mean, we're not talking cheap guitar, so this is Australian $6,000 and seven and a bit for the K, so...
It's, to put the case into perspective, for those viewing at home, it's probably a little bit more rigid than a mono.
Oh, yeah.
Isn't it? Like, yeah. There's a level of something incredibly hard in there. I think it may be titanium. Good stuff. Oh.
So, what else do we want to talk about? I reckon that sums it up. Maybe just
play a few.
We'll have you do like a bit of a playthrough on both of them. Do the same thing. We'll get Nick to do it because Nick's good at doing these playthroughs. And put them side by side, and you can make up your own mind as to what you like.
Yeah, and come into the shop and try them out because, I mean, you know, you can take our word for it if you want, but also you could just make up your own mind about things.
Yeah, that'd be a great idea.
Here's some sound samples.
There we go.